गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। सो बिफोर आई बिगिन विश यू ऑल हैप्पी लोरी, मकर संक्रांत, बिहू, पोंगल और इन सिंपल वर्ड्स सन्स जर्नी बैक टू द नदर हेमिस्फीयर। दैट इज द So we were doing the Himalayas. So I'll quickly revise the Great Himalayas. The Great Himalayas, highest mountains in the world. Most of the peaks are snow covered because they are greater than 8000 in height. They are the oldest of all the Himalayas because they were the first Himalayas to be formed. They start and end abruptly. The place where they stand and start and end abruptly is known as syntaxial bend or the U-shaped bend. The U-shaped bend is caused due to the two arms of peninsular India. Fine with this? Then the second Zaskar range of the Great Himalayas and the Pir Panjal range of the Middle Himalayas, in ke beach is the Valley of Kashmir. Through how many states do we have Great Himalayas?
11.
The states through which Great Himalayas pass, not Himalayas, Great Himalayas. Namcha Barua to Nanga Parvat, gino kitne states hai? Jammu and Kashmir, Nanga Parvat, हिमाचल प्रदेश, उत्तराखंड, सिक्किम, अरुणाचल प्रदेश। सो द फाइव स्टेट्स है जिसमें से द ग्रेट हिमालयास पास, नॉट द हिमालयास, द ग्रेट हिमालयास पास थ्रू द फाइव स्टेट्स ऑफ इंडिया। फाइन विद दिस? देन वी कम टू द मिडल हिमालयास। द मिडल हिमालयास वेयर फॉर्म्ड ड्यूरिंग द आफ्टर द ग्रेट हिमालयास, वी नो द एज इज नोन एज मियोसीन पीरियड। So when the Great Himalayas were formed, numerous glaciers and rivers originated from the Great Himalayas and they carried large amount of sediments. So over the period of time, after the formation of the Middle Himalayas, these rivers were obstructed by the Middle Himalayas and therefore they deposited the sediments between the Great and the Middle Himalayas, and these sediments are known as karevas. So karevas are fluvio-glacial deposits of boulder, clay, etc. And they are, the entire Kashmir valley is made up of karevas. Are they fertile? Yes, they are mostly fertile for temperate crops. The most important crop is saffron. Now because it is a plain region, it is a flat region. So river Jhelum, which should go through very fast because this is the youthful stage. Entire Himalayas is youthful or old stage of a river. Youthful stage. But because it is a plain region, river Jhelum comes in the small region of plains, cuts through the middle Himalayas, fir se uska youthful stage continue hota hai. But in this region, because Jhelum originates on Zaskar, it comes here and it starts meandering. You know that when the speed decreases, it will start meandering. And because of this, we can say river Jhelum forms a temporary base level, forming a oxbow lake here. And this Oxbow Lake is also the largest freshwater lake in India, that is the Lake Vular. So Vular Lake is found in the Himalayas. It is an example of an Oxbow Lake. You know through geomorphology that Oxbow Lake should be formed in the regions which are in the old age, but still we have Oxbow Lake here because the river Jhelum is forced to slow down its speed. Why it is forced to slow down the speed? Because of the local base level. What do you mean by local base level? Itna diya hai sirf NCERT mein, because of the local base level. Base level means something which is near the sea level. So the base level should be in the old age because it comes near the sea level. But yahan pe, due to the deposition, we have a base level which is at a very, very great height and it is formed. It is a temporary phenomena. It is not a phenomena that has been caused due to erosion and the land has been made very flat. And therefore, this is known as a local base level. सो इतना सिर्फ प्रिलिम्स के लिए याद रखना है दैट वुलर लेक इज एन ऑक्सबो लेक नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ डिपोजिशन नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ मियांडर्स बट बिकॉज ऑफ द लोकल बेस लेवल फॉर्म ड्यू टू करेवास फाइन शुड आई रिपीट अगेन सो रिवर झेलम River Jhelum is forced to meander. River Jhelum is forced to meander. Is forced to meander due to deposition between Great and Middle Himalayas. Due to the deposition between the Great and the Middle Himalayas. This deposition has resulted into formation of temporary base level in the bracket local base level has resulted into the formation of temporary base level or the local base level causing river jhelum to meander forming an oxbow lake wooler lake even in youthful stage Why? Because itna zyada meandering hota hai of a river that there is an intersection and then we find this as an oxbow lake. Kahan hona chahiye? In the old age. Kahan pe milta hai? In the youthful stage. Oxbow lake, wooler lake. In the youthful stage. Fine? So is Wooler a natural lake? Yes. Next we come to the Middle Himalayas. Middle Himalayas are not continuous like the Great Himalayas. They are known by different names. And the names are, you tell me the names. They are known as Pir Panjal in Jammu and Kashmir. They are known as Dhawla Dhar in Himachal and they are known as Masuri, Nag Tibba, not UP, Uttarakhand. Out of that, Pir Panjal is famous for the tourist destination of Rohtang Pass. In which state? In the state of Himachal Pradesh. Rohtang Pass, one of the most famous tourist destination, lies in the Pir Panjal Ridge, in the state of Himachal Pradesh. We'll come to the passes. And same, that is during the formation of after the formation of Middle Himalayas, we have many rivers which cut through the Middle Himalayas. Chenab, Ravi, Bias, Satluj, Jhelum, Ganga, Yamuna, this cut through the Middle Himalayas. So when these rivers were coming down, then there was a formation of the Shivaliks. Due to the sediments which were deposited in the Tethys Sea, Tethys Geosyncline, and this rivers again were obstructed, but yahan pe they did not form as plains due to glaciers. They formed only due to rivers. And these plains are known as dunes in the western part of India and duars in the eastern part of India. Some of these plains have water in between them. And this water body is known as tals. Tal matlab lakes. They are known as TALS tals or TALS tals. So this is all we have studied. And then we know that the name of the Shivaliks in Jammu and Kashmir is Jammu Hills. In Himachal Pradesh also they are known as Jammu Hills. So Jammu Hills are the name of Shivaliks. This is what? This is Middle Himalayas. So the name is Jammu Hills. In the Uttarakhand, they are known as Kumaon or Gadwal region. Shivaliks. And in the state of Arunachal, there is no name, separate name here. They are known as Dafla, Miri, Abhur, and Mishmi. So this is how they are arranged. They are Dafla, Miri, Abhur, and Mishmi. Fine with this? Anyone has gone after the class through standard 11th and standard 10th NCERT? Yes. Any new fact in the book? No. That is why I said, usi din khatam karo, wo tension khatam ho jayega NCERT padhne ka. You will not find any new facts there. It is very much compressed. So, hardly it will take 15-20 minutes after the revision of the class notes. Class notes 1 ghanta, and after that 15-20 minutes to do that specific chapter of the NCERTs. Can I rub this part? Mountains है ना आसपास, तो झेलम जो आती है वो mountains के कारण force करता होता है meander. So ऊपर झास्कर है, नीचे पीर पंजाल है, उसको meander करके झेलम जाती है. That is why you cannot adjust. अगर वो soil होती तो base level को adjust कर लेता. Your optional is geography. Then we have the Trans-Himalayas. So what are the Trans-Himalayas? If we look at the map of India, can I say the mountains which are to the north of the Himalayas are Trans-Himalayas? So yahan se hai the Great Himalayas. So we have the Trans-Himalayas in the form of Karakoram. Karakoram ka extension is what is Ladakh. And after that we have Kailash. So Karakoram range is between three countries: Pakistan, India and China. So this mountains which were formed before the formation of the Himalayas are known as Trans-Himalayas. So why the Trans-Himalayas? Because they were formed prior to the formation of Himalayas. They were formed prior to the formation of the Himalayas. Second important thing about the Trans-Himalayas is they are of volcanic origin. They are of volcanic origin. You know the answer for this because continent-continent collision hua during the formation of Himalayas. Usse pehle there was a sea, Tethys Sea. It went below. So anything that is formed coming out of the sima, you know, it will subduct, melt, and then it will give volcanoes. And therefore, the Trans-Himalayas are of volcanic origin. So the name of Karakoram is Black Mountain. Why Black Mountain? Because it is mostly made up of basalt. Yeah, it is made up of gravel, which is black in color. And what is the other name of Karakoram? Krishna Giri. Krishna means black. Giri means mountain. So the Karakoram is Arabic name. Krishnagiri is the Indian name for that. So Karakoram or Krishnagiri mountains. What is the third most important point regarding these mountains? The third most important point regarding this mountain is, this is the most glaciated third pole of the world. This is the most glaciated third pole of the world. In other words, this is the most glaciated region outside the polar regions. And hence, important source of fresh water for South Asia and Southeast Asia, including China, East Asian country of China. Fine. Next, three important rivers originate from here. Three important rivers originate from here. One is River Indus. Jiska naam here is Singe Khamban. Next is Brahmaputra. Words nahi dikh rahe. Manu ko bula ke lao. Jiska naam is Sangpo or Brahmaputra. And the third most important river of this region is River Satluj. The third most important river of this region is River Satluj. This all originate from the Trans-Himalayas. The fourth river, which I have not taken because India ke liye itni important nahi hai, is River Mekong. Is the river Mekong. Singe Khamban Indus ka naam hai in Ladakh. Haan, but words nahi dikh rahe. So these are the four important rivers, and then you should know Indus flows between which two mountains. So Indus flows between Ladakh and Saskar ranges. Singe Khamban ka matlab hai sher ka muh. Is naam ka glacier bhi hai, but more importantly it is the name of river Indus. Kaun sa? Glacier, sare glaciers hai. Glacier, glaciated lakes hai ye. So, when the Satluj enters India, it cuts through the which Himalayas? Which are these? Great Himalayas. Forming a famous pass that is located on the Indo-China border, and this is known as a Shipkila Pass. In the state of Himachal Pradesh, forming a Shipkila Pass in the state of Himachal Pradesh. उनको कैन एवरीवन सी सो द सो हैव यू टेकन डाउन जो जो पॉइंट्स मैंने यहां लिखे. सो इंडस फ्लोज बिटवीन विच टू रेंजेस लद्दाख एंड झास्कर. इंडस फ्लोज बिटवीन द लद्दाख एंड द झास्कर रेंजेस. डू इट वेरी वेरी प्रॉपरली कि इंडस फ्लोज बिटवीन द लद्दाख एंड द झास्कर रेंजेस नॉट बिटवीन द लद्दाख एंड द काराकोरम रेंज. ऐसा लगता है हमें इंडस विल फ्लो बिटवीन लद्दाख एंड द काराकोरम रेंज बट इट फ्लोज बिटवीन द लद्दाख एंड द झास्कर रेंज. वाइल देर इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट रिवर विच फ्लोज बिटवीन लद्दाख एंड काराकोरम बिफोर ज्वाइनिंग रिवर इंडस एंड दिस इंपॉर्टेंट रिवर इज वी हैव डन दिस अर्लियर दैट इज रिवर शोक. दिस इंपॉर्टेंट रिवर इज रिवर शोक. रिवर शोक. शोक का मतलब क्या है? वाई द नेम ऑफ द रिवर इज शोक? बिकॉज इट इज नोन एज वैली ऑफ डेथ. इसलिए द रिवर का नेम इज शोक. क्योंकि ग्रेट हिमालयस का एक ब्रांच है अपर पार्ट है बट वी टेक इट एज अ पार्ट ऑफ ग्रेट हिमालयस. फाइन विद दिस. नाउ नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. Which are these two lakes in China? Mansarovar, Rakas Lake. Fine? Mansarovar, Rakas Lake. We'll write these lakes later on. Famous, सबसे deepest gorge. Fine? Next, to the north of the Trans-Himalayas, to the north of the Trans-Himalayas, to the north of the Trans-Himalayas is heavily dissected, eroded, flat region of the world known as Tibetan Plateau region. अब UPSC prelims में पूछती है. देखो इस पार्ट से mains का separate question नहीं आएगा. Write a short note on Trans Himalayas. You will ask you regarding the Himalayas only. So why it is highly dissected, why it is highly eroded? Because of the rivers. Itni sari rivers are flowing in this region. So obviously the rivers have cut through them. So therefore the answer is heavily dissected region of the world. Fine with this? Next. This region has numerous saline lakes. Konsa region? Tibetan Plateau region. This region has numerous saline lakes. This region has numerous saline lakes. For example, Salt Lake, Somoriri, Salt Lake or just right, Salt Lake and Pangong So. Salt Lake and the Pangong So. Fine. इस region में plains भी है जो हमने India China में लिखा है. What are the name of the plains? Soda Plains. उसके बाद Lingitiang Plains and third is Deepsang Plains. So this region is covered by numerous plains. Plains क्यों है? Suppose this is a flat region. Now the river has cut through the flat region. So दो flat region बन गए. एक का नाम हो गया Deepsang Plains, एक का नाम हो गया Soda Plains. Getting this? And last very important point. The Karakoram Ladakh region has India's largest notified protected area. Largest notified protected area in the bracket, इसका मतलब है national park. Largest notified protected area, national park known as Hemis National Park. Why is Hemis National Park famous? Highest density of the snow leopards in the world. So Hemis National Park, highest density of snow leopard in the world. Highest density of snow leopards in the world. So which state is the Hemis National Park? Jammu and Kashmir. So remember, which is the largest national park in India? Jammu and Kashmir. The Hemis National Park. It lies in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, but in the regions of Ladakh. You cannot say kaun sa range mein, kyunki some part of it comes in Zaskar. Some part of it comes near the Indus. Some part of it comes under the Karakoram region. So it is not a single region. Therefore, it is the largest national park in India. It is famous for snow leopards. Next is the Eastern Himalayas. Eastern Himalayas, or they are also known as collectively as Purvanchal. They are collectively known as Purvanchal. And we have already done this. Are the other Himalayas east west or north south mountains? East to west. So these are north south low mountains as compared to Himalayas. Inki height is less, forming a natural boundary between, you already know which two countries? India and Myanmar. India and Burma, Myanmar. And कौन से mountains है वो हमने किए हैं? पटकाई बम, उसके बाद नागा, उसके बाद मिजो हिल्स, मणिपुर हिल्स, एंड उसके बाद लुशाई और मिजो हिल्स. सो इसको नॉर्थ टू साउथ याद रखना वेरी प्रॉपरली. दे आर पटकाई बम, नागा, मणिपुर एंड मिजो. मणिपुर में दो तीन है, ईस्ट मणिपुर, वेस्ट मणिपुर. व्हाई इज दिस फेमस? कल अगर क्वेश्चन आता है व्हाई इज पटकाई बम फेमस, कौन सी रिवर ओरिजिनेट होती है यहां से? चिंदविन रिवर. व्हाई इज द नागा हिल्स फेमस? विच इज द माउंटेन हियर हाइएस्ट पीक? साबरमती इज इन गुजरात, इट इज सारामती. साबरमती क्या संत गांधी जी को कहते हैं. सो इट इज इन गुजरात. देन लोकटक लेक. कोई रिवर ओरिजिनेट होती है? यस, बराक रिवर. बराक, बराक ओबामा कम्स फ्रॉम हियर. सो रिवर बराक. देन आफ्टर दैट वी हैव ब्लू माउंटेन्स और लुशाई हिल्स. फाइन, द ईस्टर्न हिमालयस. नो नीड ऑफ रिपीटिंग अगेन. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, the eastern himalayas continue in Myanmar as Arakan Mountains. As the Arakan Yoma Mountains. A-R-A-K-A-N, Arakan Yoma Mountains. Which further continues southwards. As Andaman and Nicobar Islands. And therefore we can say Andaman and Nicobar Islands are the extension of Himalayas. Fine? Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Fine? Period. Miocene to Pliocene. Long period of formation. उसके जस्ट बाद उसके शिवालिक्स के साथ साथ फाइन इनके हाइट इज इट ग्रेटर देन द नाउ सी सम ऑफ द प्रीलिम्स बेस्ड क्वेश्चन व्हिच दे विल चेक द कॉन्सेप्ट्स इज देयर हाइट ग्रेटर ऑफ द पूर्वांचल हिल्स देन अदर हिमालयस और लेसर लेसर सेकंड डू दे फॉर्म अ प्रॉपर वाटर डिवाइड Are Himalayas a perfect water divide? Agar aisa question aata hai kal. Water divide means two different rivers originate and flow in two different directions. So Himalayas, no. Most of the rivers which originate in the Himalayas come towards India. Fine. So Himalayas is not a perfect water divide. But is the Purvanchal Hills a perfect water divide? Yes. So you should remember, Purvanchal Hills are the perfect water divide. Because Brahmaputra, Indian side, Iravadi River on the Myanmar side. Fine. Only for prelims. What are the important passes in the Himalayas? So you can draw this diagram. First we'll do the passes of the Great Himalayas. And the most important, passes. Jitna main de raha hu utna hi karna. Don't go by the मटेरियल उसमें सारे के सारे पासेस दिए हैं वैसे 3000 पासेस है इंडिया में सो दैट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड वी शुड रिमेंबर इट फ्रॉम द स्टेट वाइज व्हाट आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट पासेस सो द सबसे पहला हियर इज बुर्जिल पास इज द बुर्जिल पास I can say Burzil Pass. थोड़ा आगे आ जाओ हाँ Burzil Pass. This one. Burzil Pass. Is it visible now? Burzil Pass. A connecting link between India and Afghanistan. And other Central Asian countries. So you know what is pass? I'll come to that. Connecting link between India and Afghanistan and other Central Asian countries. Other Central Asian countries. अभी बंद है. क्यों बंद है? Because अगर ये खुला रखा तो this is India, this is POK. Understanding? So it is not working. Second important pass is Jo Jila. Is the Jo Jila? Can anyone tell me why is the Jo Jila important? Why? No, not Karakoram Highway. It connects Srinagar with Leh. It connects Srinagar to Leh. So Srinagar Leh Highway passes through this. So this is the second pass. Srinagar Leh Highway passes through this. Kargil sab isi route pe hai. Srinagar Leh Highway passes through this. Good road, bad road. Anyone has gone through this? Yes, it is a good road. Aap Leh Activa leke bhi ja sakte ho. It is that good road. Srinagar to Leh. But agar adventure karna hai, so these are the two important passes of Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir. But agar aapko adventure karna hai, so you have to go to Himachal Pradesh. And the third pass is Bara Lachala. Why is it important? In the Himachal Pradesh, Bara Lachala. Manali Leh Highway. Manali Leh Highway. Anyone has traveled through Bara Lachala? So, Manali Leh Highway. One of the most dangerous roads of the world. Manali Leh Highway. Bara Lachala. It passes through the Bara Lachala pass. You remember what is the pass? The Great Himalaya should have been continuous, but rivers have eroded and therefore there are some of the deep valleys. On deep valleys say we can cross the Himalayas and these are the passes. Hoti hai bridge hai, roads hai side mein. ये माउंटेन है, ये वैली है रिवर की, यहाँ पे हम रोड बना सकते हैं. सो दैट इज वाई इट इज मोस्ट डेंजरस रोड, नहीं तो नदी से चले जाते. सो देन वी हैव द अनदर मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पास जो यूपीएससी का फेवरेट है, इज द शिपकिला पास. इज द शिपकिला पास क्यों इंपॉर्टेंट है? रिवर इंडस एंटर्स इंडिया? नो, रिवर सतलज एंटर्स इंडिया थ्रू शिपकिला पास. रिवर सतलज एंटर्स इंडिया थ्रू शिपकिला पास. रिवर सतलज एंटर्स इंडिया थ्रू शिपकिला पास विथ स्टेट अगेन हिमाचल प्रदेश. इट इज ऑल्सो अ ट्रेड रूट बिटवीन इंडिया एंड तिब्बत. Also a trade route between India and Tibet. A trade route between India and Tibet. Then we come to the state of Uttarakhand and we have three important passes here. Which one? Nitila. Manala and Lipule. Nitila, Manala, Lipule. Direct question aata hai, Nitila, Manala and Lipule passes are in which state of India? So, 5th, 6th, 7th. That is Nitila. La means pass. Manala and Lipule. These are in the state of Uttarakhand. This is in the state of Himachal Pradesh. These two. Out of that, Nitila is not important, Manala is not important, Lipule is important. You know this, the importance of Lipule is Kailash Mansarovar Yatra. Amarnath Yatra route is through which pass? Through? Pir Panjal Pass region, that is through the in the Pir Panjal ranges, you can say. Kailash Mansarovar Yatra route goes through this pass. And you already know this is at a tri-junction of India, Nepal and China. Then we have two important passes here. One is Jelepla. And the other is Nathula. Nathula, Jelepla and Nathula. Which state? The state of Sikkim. Both of them are an important trade route between India and China. Both of them are an important trade route between India and China. Jelepla, Dokla ke paas hai. You see, it is near the Dokla region. So, see, crossing and going through to Mansarovar through Nitila or Lipule is very difficult because you have to climb all the Himalayas. Arunachal mein Himalayas ka width decreases. And therefore, the ideal route should be crossing through Nathula and then direct gadi leke jao over to the Mansarovar Rakas Lake region. But the Chinese government allowed, and after Dokla, Chinese government has again stopped the passage through Nathula. Isle people die because crossing all the three ranges is difficult through Uttarakhand. You should know that southern side of the Himalayas is steep, Indian side. Yahan pe the steepness is less and iske upar sirf plateau hai. So directly if you go to China, you can take an vehicle right up to the Mansarovar Rakas Lake region. And the last pass in the state of Uttarakhand, in the Arunachal, is Bumla. Is Bumla. There is one more pass we have done that day. Is Bomdila. But don't write Bomdila here. I am just drawing Bomdila. Only factual data. They will ask you the questions in some story format. A region in India is an important route for Mansarovar Yatra and also lies at the tri-junction of three countries and drained by a river which is known as Sharda. Identify the region. So, which is that? Lipule. Sharda River, Kalapani region. Can I rub this part? Thank you. passes in Middle Himalayas. Passes in the Middle Himalayas, and the most important pass in the Pir Panjal range. Jammu in Kashmir, first we'll do. In the Middle Himalayas, Pir Panjal range is Banihal Pass. Is the Banihal Pass. Why it is most important out of all the passes? It is a connecting link between Jammu and Srinagar. Connecting link between Jammu and Srinagar. Connecting link between Jammu and Srinagar. Once upon a time, it was the longest tunnel in India. Uske baad Jawahar Tunnel. So we have the longest tunnel. Once upon a time, the longest tunnel in India, Jawahar Tunnel. Uske baad ab ban gaya isi Pir Panjal mein, nearby this Banihal Pass is the Chenani Nashri Tunnel. Chenani Nashri Tunnel, which was opened in 2015 by Prime Minister Modi. And isi ke pass, near the Pir Panjal Pass, we have the first railway link in Kashmir Valley, that is Baramulla Kazikund Railway Link. Fine, should I write all these things? So the Banihal Pass, sabse pehle you should know, it is the connecting link between Jammu and Srinagar. National Highway 1 A or D?
D, D sir.
1 D. Aur uska naya naam hai National Highway 44. National Highway 1D or National Highway 44. Jammu Srinagar. Longest railway tunnel, 2.5 km ka railway tunnel tha. No, road tunnel tha, known as Jawahar Tunnel. Then, second, now the longest road tunnel in India is Chenani Nashri Tunnel. Sab ek udhar hi hai. Chenani Nashri Tunnel. Chenani Nashri Tunnel. Longest road tunnel. Road tunnel. Bhul gaya main bhi. 5:30 ke aas paas. Longest yahi hai. Railway tunnel nahi, road tunnel. कौन सा है? But officially यही longest है. अभी तो यही बोल रहे हैं. And through the Pir Panjal passes, passes Kazikund Baramulla Railway Link. The first railway in Kashmir Valley. You should remember there is a lot of difference between Jammu. Jammu ka climate, Jammu ka everything is same like India, tropics and subtropics. And then you go through the Jawahar Tunnel. 15 minute baad when you cross and come in the Kashmir Valley, scenery alag ho jati hai. Totally. It is worth travelling through the Jawahar Tunnel. पहले कुछ नहीं ऐसे bore होते हो आप कि क्या कश्मीर जा रहे हो क्यों जा रहे हो इतना लंबा रास्ता. Then as soon as the Jawahar Tunnel comes and you cross through that Jawahar Tunnel and go in the Kashmir Valley, pura tropics, tropical vegetation gives sudden rise to the alpine forest, snow covered mountains. So that is the Jawahar Tunnel, Chenani Nashri Tunnel या Kazikund Baramulla Railway Link. First, Himalayas did not have railways. Now, most of the Himalayan states have railways, except there is no railway in only one state of India. Northeast ka ek state mein abhi railway nahi hai. Sikkim is there. Dusra, Arunachal Pradesh now has railway. Meghalaya does not have railway. So we'll come to that when we'll do the state of Meghalaya. second important pass. Again in the state of Jammu and Kashmir is Pir Panjal Pass. Is the Pir Panjal Pass. अब देखो chances बहुत कम है question आने के कि Pir Panjal Pass lies in which ranges of India. So answer is Pir Panjal range. So you just remember the state Jammu and Kashmir. Then we have the third in the state of Himachal Pradesh as Rohtang Pass. As the Rohtang Pass. This is all the important passes in the Himalayas. बाकी के कोई जरूरत नहीं है. जैसे Western Ghats में भी तीन चार passes हैं important. बाकी के जरूरत नहीं है. Fine with this? Can I rub this part? How many glaciers are there in Himalayas? बहुत सारे मतलब कितने? So how many glaciers? कुछ figure थोड़ा अंदाज डाल के. There are 15,000 glaciers in the Himalayas. So depend करता है. एक glacier मतलब एक source of a river. एक कोरी से निकल रहा है वो एक glacier. So the important glaciers are. इंडिया के ही हम कर रहे हैं. यस सियाचिन ग्लेशियर इन द काराकोरम रेंजेस. सियाचिन ग्लेशियर इन द काराकोरम रेंजेस. सियाचिन ग्लेशियर इन द काराकोरम. You already know about the Siachen Glacier, the longest glacier outside the polar regions. But it is the longest glacier outside the polar regions. Hispar bhi hai, Baltoro bhi hai, but they are in Pakistan occupied Kashmir. Agar aapko yaad rakhna hai, to ek aur glacier hai yahan pe, that is Hispar Glacier. So all these are in the Trans-Himalayas. Yes. Baltoro uske baju mein. Then in the state of Uttarakhand. Dekho, baki ke glaciers hum rivers ke saath karenge. Jahan jahan koi river major originate ho rahi hai. In the state of Uttarakhand, we have three important glaciers. Yamunitri Glacier, Gangotri Glacier and Pindar Glacier. This all are right. So, I have Chandrapani Glacier also skipped kiya hai because we will do while doing the Chenab River. Yamunitri, Gangotri and the Pindar Glacier. And lastly, this glacier is important in Sikkim, that is Zemu Glacier. तिस्ता वहां से नहीं, तिस्ता थोड़े नॉर्थ से निकलती है, जेमू ग्लेशियर। सो जस्ट अभी ग्लेशियर का आइडिया रखो, जब हम रिवर्स करेंगे तो यू विल हैव एन आइडिया रिगार्डिंग द ग्लेशियर्स। अभी तक क्वेश्चन नहीं आया है ऑन द ग्लेशियर्स, फाइन। अगर आता है तो देयर विल बी ग्लेशियर लैंड फॉर्म्स व्हिच वी हैव कवर्ड इन जियोमॉर्फोलॉजी, फाइन विद दिस। कैन आई रैप दिस पार्ट? These are exactly in this order. In the case the question अगर पूछते हैं north to south या east to west, this is the order. Hispar, Siachen, Yamunotri, Gangotri, Pindar, Zemu Glacier. अब देखो you should also know the questions. क्यों पूछेंगे वो गंगोत्री यमुनोत्री ग्लेशियर? सबको पता है गंगोत्री यानी यमुनोत्री ग्लेशियर कहाँ पे है, क्या इनका इंपॉर्टेंस है। पूछेंगे पिंडार ग्लेशियर कहाँ पे है, उत्तराखंड, विच रेंज ऑफ उत्तराखंड, नंदा देवी हिल्स, नंदा देवी रेंजेस। जेमू ग्लेशियर कहाँ पे है, बिकॉज इट इज नियर डोकला एक्सेट्रा, सो दे मे आस्क यू अबाउट द जेमू ग्लेशियर, फाइन। अब स्किप कर रहा हूं मैं रेमो ग्लेशियर, आसपास ही है वो। सो यहाँ पे इतने ज्यादा ग्लेशियर्स हैं कि मैंने ये बियाफो, बालतोरो, बाटूरा, हिस्पार वो सारे स्किप किए। कैन आई रैप दिस पार्ट? Now, some of the points regarding the Himalayas, you tell me whether I am right or wrong. Himalayas are wider in the west and narrow in the east, comparatively. Yes. Remember? Geomorphology ke samay, the Himalayas are much wider in the west. Great Himalayas, Middle Himalayas, and Shivaliks. So they are wider in the east and the narrow in the, sorry, they are narrow in the east and wider in the west. Fine with this? Second important point regarding the Himalayas, that Himalayas sag southwards and they are more to the south in the western part. True or false? In the eastern part, they are more to the south and more nearer to the Tropic of Cancer. Third, Himalayas cross the Tropic of Cancer. Yes, they cross the Tropic of Cancer, right? Fourth important thing regarding the Himalayas, okay? The Himalayas have been formed due to three consecutive collisions. True or false? Yes, they are formed due to three collisions. I'm just revising this. We have done all these things. Fine with this? Himalayas are good in mineral deposits. You find petrol in the Himalayas. True or false? True. We'll see the importance of the Himalayas. Now you only tell me quickly what are the importance of the Himalayas. And ye hai mains and prelims dono ke liye. So what is the first importance of the Himalayas? क्या करता है? Does it stop the monsoon winds which otherwise monsoon winds would have crossed the Himalayas? Fine. Second, does it stop the cold wind during this season? Otherwise Mongolia से, China के desert से the cold wind should have come and it would have come to India. Third, does it help in the formation of monsoon? Yes. Kaise? I'll quickly revise. Sabse pehle Tibetan Plateau, Great Himalayas, Middle Himalayas, Shivaliks, and this do not allow the monsoon winds to go, and therefore we get monsoon rainfall. Fine. they do not allow the cold winds to enter. So we have done in geomorphology that the northern slopes of the Himalayas are have more snow cover. And third important, ki if the Tibetan plateau is heated, we'll do again this in the monsoons. Jitna the Tibetan plateau is heated, there is a formation of low pressure over Tibet. The air comes up and it starts coming south to the south, and this results into the formation of easterly jet stream. So the first importance I'll give you in points. Climatic importance. Climatic importance. Climatic importance. First, climatic importance. They stop the summer monsoon winds. They stop the summer monsoon winds or the southwest monsoon winds. Southwest monsoon winds causing precipitation in Indian subcontinent, in the Indian subcontinent. Second, during the winter season the Himalayas stop. The cold winds from the north. Himalayas stop the cold winds from the north from entering into India. Third, आज हवा चल रही थी थोड़ी ज्यादा. व्हाट डज इट इंडिकेट? इट इंडिकेट्स कि आफ्टर 3-4 डेज देयर विल बी वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस इन इंडिया. द विंड्स आर ब्लोइंग, द जेट स्ट्रीम हैज बिकम स्ट्रॉन्गर. सो आफ्टर यू सी देयर इज अ क्लीन स्काई, दो तीन दिन बाद आपको सीरियस क्लाउड्स दिखेंगे एंड उसके बाद देयर विल बी विंटर रेनफॉल इन इंडिया नेक्स्ट ट्यूजडे. वैसे तो होनी चाहिए थी आज कल में ही, बट यू कैन नॉट प्रेडिक्ट द विंड्स. सो दिस आर वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस. ये पॉइंट भी है क्लाइमेट में. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, ड्यू टू द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द हिमालयास द वेस्टर्ली जेट स्ट्रीम इज डिवाइडेड इंटू टू पार्ट्स. Westerly jet stream is divided into two parts, which gives rainfall and snowfall. आपको पता है rainfall southern या northern branch? Rainfall southern branch. See, Indian geography पूरा application है जो तक हम अभी तक हमने पढ़ा है उसका. It is nothing new, no conceptual part. Rainfall southern part. And snowfall, northern branch. Fine? Known as western disturbances. Fine? Next. The subtropical easterly jet stream, climate में ही, the subtropical easterly jet stream, ये एक एक point prelims के लिए important है. The subtropical easterly jet stream is responsible for the formation of, sorry, the subtropical easterly jet stream is formed due to heating of Tibetan plateau. Due to the heating of Tibetan plateau. And subtropical easterly jet stream, आगे का in Indian monsoon, it determines the kind of winds that are coming to India. And last, but the most important point, again, generally we miss this point. due to the presence of Himalayas, a portion of Bay of Bengal branch, of southwest monsoon is deflected towards India. Bay of Bengal branch of southwest monsoon current is deflected towards India. ये भी शायद मैंने बताया था आपको पहले. फाइन, संतोष सर ने आपको क्वेश्चन पूछा भी है, अरेबियन सी ब्रांच इज स्ट्रॉन्गर और द बे ऑफ बंगाल ब्रांच इज स्ट्रॉन्गर. सो विच इज स्ट्रॉन्गर? अरेबियन सी ब्रांच. क्यों? क्योंकि एंटायर अरेबियन सी ब्रांच कम्स टू इंडिया. यू हैव रिटन हियर कि द पोर्शन ऑफ द बे ऑफ बंगाल ब्रांच कम्स टू इंडिया, बाकी का चला जाता है इन द साउथ वेस्ट, साउथ ईस्ट एशिया. फाइन, सो कंक्लूजन याद रखना, In the absence of Himalayas, India would have been a konsa desert, hot or cold? India would have been a hot desert during summers, and cold desert during winters. Hot desert during the summers and cold desert during winters. कोल्ड डेजर्ट क्योंकि वो बर्फ वाली हवा आती, हॉट डेजर्ट इसलिए क्योंकि ट्रॉपिक ऑफ कैंसर हमारे ऊपर आता. क्या? यस, ईरान. ईरान इज अ परफेक्ट एग्जांपल ऑफ दिस. इन द एब्सेंस, अगर हिमालय नहीं होते तो क्या होता? अभी हिमालयाज नहीं होंगे, पॉसिबल है? पॉसिबल है 200 लाख साल बाद. सेकेंड इंपॉर्टेंस, व्हाट इज द सेकेंड इंपॉर्टेंस? ऑफ हिमालयाज? इमेजिन हिमालयाज नहीं होते तो क्या होता? चाइना इंडिया में आता, फिर क्या होता चाइना इंडिया में आके? रिवर्स, मोस्ट ऑफ द बिग रिवर्स ऑफ इंडिया कहां से ओरिजिनेट होती है? थ्रू हिमालयस. सिर्फ पानी नहीं लेके आती और कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट चीज लेके आती है, सॉइल. And the soil is deposited, resulting into formation of Great Plains. Therefore, we say Great Plains are the gift of the Himalayas, because it is the Himalayas which have helped in the formation of Great Plains. Third, because of the rivers. Rivers are mighty, or they are like peninsular rivers. They are mighty rivers. So this region is flooded, and because of floods, the people die. Understand? And because people die, animals die, fertility of the soil is very high. Humus milta hai unko, carbon milta hai, nitrogen milta hai. Understanding the soils? Imagine there is so much high population density ki we do not leave our land fallow. Fallow matlab kabhi ek saal aisa nahi hoga ki we are leaving the land and allowing it to regenerate. But still, this is one of the most fertile regions of the world. Why? Because of the rivers. एक तो हर साल नया एल्यूवियम इज डिपॉजिटेड एंड दैट एल्यूवियम इज रिच इन मोस्ट ऑफ द एनपीके. तराई रीजन में नाइट्रोजन, फास्फोरस एंड पोटैश तीनों हाई है. नाइट्रोजन फॉर लीव्स, फास्फोरस फॉर फ्लावर्स एंड पोटैश फॉर रूट्स. दिस इज हाउ दिस थ्री फर्टिलाइजर्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट. गेटिंग इट? रिवर्स है, आसानी से आती है, दे जंप बिकॉज इट इज माउंटेनियस, दे जंप एंड देयरफॉर हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिक पावर. अंडरस्टैंडिंग? तेहरी डैम, लोअर सुबानसरी प्रोजेक्ट, इंडस वाटर ट्रीटी, ऑल दिस किशन गंगा प्रोजेक्ट, ऑल दिस इज पॉसिबल. हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिक पावर पोटेंशियल इज वेरी हाई इन इंडिया बिकॉज वी हैव हिमालयस. सो रिमेंबर, इनफैक्ट अगर हिमालयस नहीं होता इन इंडिया टूडे तो इंडिया वुड हैव बीन टू डिफरेंट नेशन, अंडरस्टैंड, बिकॉज सदर्न इंडिया कहता, आज भी कहते हैं, तो उस टाइम तो और ज्यादा कहता कि वो तो टेम्परेट है. इट इज दिस रीजन इज नॉट टेम्परेट बिकॉज ऑफ द हिमालयाज, अदरवाइज यू आर कमिंग इन द टेम्परेट लैटिट्यूड्स, बट बिकॉज ऑफ द हिमालयाज द रॉक्स गेट सो हॉट कि इवन ड्यूरिंग द विंटर सीजन डे टाइम टेम्परेचर ऑफ दिस रीजन इज सिमिलर टू द डे टाइम टेम्परेचर ऑफ द ट्रॉपिक्स. Getting it? Otherwise, in this region, you go and see the latitudes. यही latitude पे Italy भी है, इसी latitude पे थोड़ा बहुत France भी है, इसी latitude पे Iran भी है. And these are temperate regions, and जहाँ पे winters are very severe. It is because of the Himalayas, Britishers used to call this region as Indian subcontinent. It is because we are isolated from rest of Asia, therefore we have understand a different type of climate. मॉनसून, ये आपका मेंस का क्वेश्चन है. दैट इज व्हाई इंडिया इज नोन एज एन इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट. वी हैव अ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ क्लाइमेट मॉनसून, वी हैव अ डिफरेंट ट्रॉपिकल मॉनसून. डे टाइम टेम्परेचर्स आर वेरी वेरी हाई इन इंडिया एंड देयरफॉर वी आर कंसिडर्ड अ ट्रॉपिक्स. नॉट ओनली दैट, आवर बिकॉज ऑफ द हिमालयस क्लाइमेट बन जाता है ट्रॉपिक्स एंड आवर एग्रीकल्चर इज ट्रॉपिकल. राइस इज अ क्रॉप, ट्रॉपिकल क्रॉप. शुगर केन, ट्रॉपिकल क्रॉप. कॉटन, ट्रॉपिकल क्रॉप. Is sugar cane taken in Europe? No. What is the most important source of sugar in Europe? Is beet. Remember, these are small facts jo aapko kaam aayenge in exam. Yeah? The sugar cane is a tropical crop. Tea is a tropical crop. Coffee is a tropical crop. Except for wheat, most of the crops in India are tropical in nature. Not only this, it is due to the Himalayas that our lifestyle is tropical in nature. Go to any part of India, kapde ek jaise milenge. Purane logo ke. Naye logo ko to, there is no, you can wear anything what you want, but go in any part of Indian subcontinent, whether it is Pakistan, whether it is India, whether it is Bangladesh, dhoti kurta. Ya lungi kurta. Depending, ki aap kis climatic conditions mein hai. If it is more wet, तो लुंगी is preferred क्योंकि लुंगी ऊपर नीचे की जा सकती है. So as a result of this, see if you are living in the delta regions, understand the lungi का reason क्या है. If you are living in the delta regions, जहाँ पे water level is very high, lungi is preferred. Whether it is South India, whether it is Bangladesh, fine. Secondly, except for Rajasthan, यहां पे in this part kurta pajama is preferred. Why? Because dhoti and lungi winds बहुत ज्यादा तेज होती है. So over the period of time. See, I'm not joking. I'm telling you only geographical reasons. Because in North India, summers are very very hot and winters are extremely cold and this is windy part. So dhoti and lungi cannot be preferred and therefore we wear kurta and pyjama irrespective whether you are Muslim, Christian, Hindu. The dress is same, customs are same. I told you naam alag alag hai, whether it is Bihu, whether it is Lohdi, whether it is Sankrant, whether it is Pongal, the festivals are more or less same. Naam sirf alag alag hai. Some parts of India is celebrating Sankrant, some part of India is celebrating Bihu, some part of India is celebrating Pongal. Find this. So this unity in diversity is due to Himalayas. Because we are a tropical nation, इसलिए हमारे diseases भी same है. So दिल्ली में भी चिकनगुनिया है, केरला में भी चिकनगुनिया है, दिल्ली में भी मलेरिया है and केरला में भी, and the same applies to even dengue. Otherwise you won't find this three diseases which I have mentioned is in the temperate regions. Actually they should not be here, but because we are tropics, we have this. This was your 2017 का question. ऐसे लगता है social issues का question है, but you cannot write this. Because of the, and why we are considered as a tropical nation? Because we have a tropical mindset. What is a tropical mindset? Tropics are blessed by resources, by climate. अभी तो global warming के कारण the temperature has increased. That is a different issue. But tropics were blessed in the terms of agriculture resources, in the terms of other resources, and therefore by nature we are lazy people because we have everything in abundance. Yahi you go to Nordics, यही यू गो टू जापान वेर ईच एंड एवरी मूवमेंट यू हैव टू सर्वाइव, यू हैव टू फाइट अगेंस्ट द नेचर, देन यू विल बी ऑलवेज अलर्ट, मेंटली अलर्ट. बिकॉज ऐसे नहीं होगा उत्तराखंड में या हिमाचल में या जम्मू कश्मीर में गाड़ी लेके जा रहे हो और नींद आ गई तो डायरेक्ट खाई में नीचे गाड़ी. सो द पीपल आर अलर्ट ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. इंडियंस एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस वी आर बॉर्न लेजी. एंड इंडियंस हो, पाकिस्तानी हो, बांग्लादेशी हो, नेपाली हो, भूटानीज हो एंड श्रीलंका, वी आर ब्लेस्ड बाय द रिसोर्सेस, वी आर लेजी. आवर एग्रीकल्चर इज मोर ऑफ एन सब्सिस्टेंस एग्रीकल्चर रादर देन ऑफ ऑफ द कमर्शियल एग्रीकल्चर. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द डाइवर्सिटी वी हैव द डाइवर्सिटी इवन एट द नेशनल लेवल. दैट मीन्स देर इज अ स्मॉल कंसेप्ट विच इज नोन एज सोशल कैपिटल. सोशल कैपिटल इज अ कंसेप्ट विद हाउ मच यू थिंक यू आर इंडियन. सो इन द साउथ एशिया, ये यूनाइटेड नेशंस का कंसेप्ट है. इन साउथ एशिया सोशल कैपिटल इज डॉर्मेंट. इन अफ्रीका सोशल कैपिटल इज एबसेंट. इन यूरोप सोशल कैपिटल इज वेरी हाई. सोशल कैपिटल दे विल ऑलवेज रियलाइज दे आर बिलोंग टू अ यूएस सिटीजन और यूरोपियन सिटीजन. इंडियंस विल रियलाइज दे आर इंडियन सिटीजन इन इफ देर इज इंडिया पाकिस्तान का क्रिकेट मैच, अंडरस्टैंडिंग, और इफ देर इज एनी काइंड ऑफ एन डिजास्टर. अदरवाइज वॉट हैज हैपेंड इन इंडिया, जहां पे ग्रेट प्लेन्स ऑफ पंजाब एज फॉर्म्ड, वी हैव पंजाब एज अ स्टेट. In this entire North India, where Hindi is a language, climate change hota hai and the states differ. In the semi-arid regions of the Hindi heartland, you have Haryana. In the upper Ganga plains, jahan pe Bhabar belt hai, you have UP, Western UP. In the lower Ganga plains, you have Bihar. In the Delta region, you have West Bengal. And in the desert region, you have Rajasthan. So this is, but Hindi is the common link. Hindi becomes a common link, but the only thing is geography changes. Geography changes and therefore plateau ban jata hai. You have Madhya Bharat Pathar or Madhya Pradesh. Fine. Even these states have been divided on the basis of, you can say, natural resources and geography. That is the most densely forested part of Madhya Pradesh ban jata hai Chhattisgarh. A forested part of Bihar ban jata hai Jharkhand. ग्रेट प्लेन्स यूपी का हिली पार्ट बन जाता है उत्तराखंड. अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस, यू विल सी डाइवर्सिटी मोर इन द सदर्न पेनिनसुला. वंस यू क्रॉस द नर्मदा, द ब्लैक सॉइल वाला रीजन बिकम्स महाराष्ट्र, रेड सॉइल वाला रीजन बिकम्स कर्नाटक, कड़प्पा सेडिमेंट्स वाला रीजन बिकम्स तेलंगाना एंड आंध्र प्रदेश. टूडे इट हैज अगेन बी डिवाइडेड ऑन द ज्योग्राफी. दैट इज द इंटीरियर पार्ट ऑफ द प्लेटू इज तेलंगाना, कोस्टल रीजन इज आंध्र प्रदेश एंड द फॉरेस्टेड रीजन इज रायलसीमा. The west and east coastal plains, they have different culture and therefore we have Tamil Nadu and Kerala. Go to northeast, Shivaliks is Arunachal Pradesh, Dafla, Miri, Abor, Mishmi. Fine. Naga Hills is Nagaland, Manipur Hills is Manipur, Mizo Hills is Mizoram, Delta is Tripura, Peninsular Plateau is Meghalaya, Garo, Khasi, Jaintia and the Brahmaputra Plains is Assam. So this is what is we are known as tropics. Understanding? Because as the climate changes, your occupation changes. Your climate, geography say, soil changes, your occupation changes and your culture changes. Culture is always, your economic occupation will determine the culture. And culture is used for division. Getting it? So this is why we are known as tropical nation. That is, in India, we say, thankfully, we have unity in diversity. I guess all science students must have done heartland and rimland theories, MacIndar. So you know that we are a part of rimland. We are a part of rimland. And kya kehta hai Spike Man? Rimland ko capture karo, you are going to capture the world. Understanding this? So you can take down the rivers. The Himalayas are the source of perennial rivers, perennial rivers, which has deposited large amount of alluvium, forming the Great Plains of India. Plains of India, forming the Great Plains of India. Because the rivers are perennial, perennial means water throughout the year. What happens? This is a region of intensive agriculture. This is the region of intensive agriculture. Intensive agriculture, each and every part of the land is used for agriculture. That is intensive agriculture. Because of the soft soil, and perennial rivers, canal irrigation dominates in this part of India. Canal irrigation dominates in North India. Canal kab banaoge aap? Two conditions are there. The land has to be flat. It is there. Digging is easy. Soft soil. And canal banane ke baad usme pani hona chahiye. So the perennial rivers. Second, the soft soil allows percolation of groundwater. Water can easily percolate down. Percolation of groundwater. Therefore, water table is high, and hence in recent times, well and tube well irrigation is the preferred irrigation. Well and tube well irrigation is the preferred irrigation. Well and tube well irrigation is the preferred irrigation. Fine. So, ek to motor ya fir canal. Well and tube well irrigation. Next point. Percolation of any water. Groundwater as a rainwater also, and as a flood water also. Soil hai yahan pe. I guess I have told you earlier also why well and tube well irrigation is not important in peninsula, because niche rock hai. So the water cannot go down and settle. North India mein why we have well and tube well irrigation? Because water table is high, was supposed to be high. Ab har jagah boring hai, har ghar mein boring hai. That is why the water table is going down. But ideally this is the condition. Isliye to ye itna densely populated region hai. Next, these rivers have high kinetic energy. Why kinetic energy is high? Because they are coming down, and hence hydroelectric power potential, not generation, potential. Hydroelectric power potential is very high in Himalayas. Very high in Himalayas, especially Arunachal. Highest hydroelectric power potential in India is Arunachal Pradesh. Especially Arunachal. Why Arunachal Pradesh? Narrow region. So the rivers are forced to jump. Any third importance of Himalayas? Biodiversity. So Himalayas are the biodiversity hotspots. Now what are hotspots? Hotspots are given on two conditions. Ek to endemism, matlab the species will be found only in that region, is very high, and second, that area is under threat. So Himalayas are very high in biodiversity. When they are one of the 36 biodiversity hotspots of the world, the diversity is very high. You find temperate vegetation there. Understanding? Because temperate vegetation, cold climate hai. Aur upar jaoge to climate still becomes colder. You find tundra vegetation there, Mount Everest, etc. You find tropical vegetation there, especially in the southern parts, and therefore you will find tigers also there. I have given you an example. You will find squirrels also there. You will find the panda also there, and you will find deer also. Deer may be itni variety. You will find barking deer, you will find musk deer, you will find the normal deer, you will find the spotted deer, you will find barasinga. There will be different kind of biodiversity and different kind of birds will be there in Himalayas. Biodiversity is not just seen in the terms of animal or the plant life, animal life, birds, animals, flora, fauna. That is, even the plants are very, very important. And Himalayan plants traditionally are extremely rich source of medicine. Extremely rich source of medicine, especially of Ayurveda. Especially of Ayurveda. Abhi हिमालयन यू आपके 10th स्टैंडर्ड की एनसीईआरटी में एक छोटा दिया है हिमालयन यू इट इज यूज्ड फॉर टैक्सोल एंड टैक्सोल इज एंटी कैंसरस ये एनसीईआरटी में दिया है अब करंट अफेयर्स इसको आगे लेके जाओ इस साल यूनाइटेड नेशंस यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स का फूड एंड ड्रग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन हैज अलाउड द टैबलेट्स और द मेडिसिन मेड फ्रॉम टैक्सोल टू बी सोल्ड इन द यूएसए बिकॉज हिमालयन यू से ज्यादा प्रॉमिसिंग एंटी कैंसरस ड्रग कहीं और मिला नहीं है सो दिस इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ द हिमालयस दे आर वेरी हाई इन बायोडाइवर्सिटी सो यू कैन टेक डाउन आई विल गिव यू सम पॉइंट्स अगेन बिकॉज द हिमालयस गो थ्रू डिफरेंट बायोजियोग्राफिक जोन्स हिमालयस गो थ्रू डिफरेंट बायोजियोग्राफिक और क्लाइमेटिक जोन्स biogeographic or climatic zones climatic zones biodiversity is very high in the Himalayas biodiversity is very high in the Himalayas in the Himalayas there is a succession of vegetation from tropical In the Himalayas, there is a succession of vegetation from tropical to tundra. To tundra. As per the height. There is a succession of vegetation. This is what succession of vegetation means. Niche tropical, upper temperate, uske upper alpine, uske upper tundra. Succession of vegetation from tropical to tundra. The biodiversity is very high, especially in the eastern Himalayas. The biodiversity is very high, especially in the eastern Himalayas. Especially in the eastern Himalayas. Because this region is nearer to the Tropic of Cancer and the coast. This region is nearer to the Tropic of Cancer and the coast, that is the sea, is a junction of great middle Shivaliks, is a junction of great middle Shivaliks and eastern Himalayas and hence Hence, this region gets very, very heavy rainfall. This region gets very, very heavy rainfall, comma, as per the height, soil varies. As per the height, soil varies. Soil varies because climate changes. Because the climate changes. Height, soil varies because the climate changes. The Northeast India in general, the Northeast India in general is very rich in biodiversity. Is very rich in biodiversity because it is a junction of Himalayan ecological region. Junction of Himalayan ecological region. Next, Indo-Burma ecological region. Indo-Burma ecological region. Indo-Burma ecological region. Peninsular ecology. Peninsula kahan pe hai? Meghalaya. Peninsular ecosystem. Peninsular ecosystem. And the Great Plains ecosystem. The Great Plains ecosystem. Sundaland niche, Andaman and Nicobar. Andaman is different ecosystem. Sundaland biodiversity also. Geological extension, ecological extension. So you have 2-3 past year questions. Ki why rainfall is heavy in the Himalayas? Because, or why the biodiversity is heavy in the Himalayas? Because the rainfall is heavy, or because it is located in the different biogeographic zones. What is the correct answer? Sirf rainfall heavy hone se biodiversity hoti nahi hai. Rainfall heavy is even in the Western Ghats. But udhar sirf ek hi milega, tropical evergreen forest. Why Himalayas have different biodiversity? Because height badhti hai. Because the height badhti hai, the temperature changes. As the temperature changes, plants change. As the plants change, soil changes. Understanding? So you have to choose very right answer from the Indian geography at this part, because the questions are conceptual. And bar bar apne notes padho, you will not miss a single question. Because Indian geography ya total geography mein se, again polity mein se, modern India mein se, and economics mein se, core jo char subjects hai, in mein se wrong mat hone do. Even if you solve 70, इसमें से मेक श्योर दैट अराउंड 55 इज राइट. गेटिंग इट? 55 टू 60 इज राइट. फोर्थ Because of high biodiversity, fourth importance, because of high biodiversity, Himalayas have immense cultural values, because of high biodiversity, Himalayas have immense cultural value. Cultural value in the form of religious tourism. See, when you go to any of a temple in the Himalayas, it is a kind of a tourism itself. It is a kind of tourism. The only thing is, usko hum kahenge religious tourism in the form of raw materials, or you can remember medicines. Especially for Ayush system, Ayush medicine system. What is Ayush? Ayurveda, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy. This is the Ayush and Chinese medicine. Ayush is our traditional medicine. Ayurveda, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy. Ayush and Chinese medicine. Next, usme se what is you should remember in 10th NCERT. Abhi to current mein kuch nahi hai. In 10th NCERT you should remember is that there is a tree which is known as Himalayan yew. It is an evergreen coniferous forest. Tree found in the Himalayas. Not evergreen tropical tree found in the Himalayas. Keyword is coniferous tree. It is now in the IUCN Red List category because it is used for collecting taxol. Taxol is the most important ingredient that comes out the Himalayan yew. And taxol is used high demand in the world because it is used to treat cancer. And results are very, very encouraging of the taxol, Himalayan yew. Himalayan yews may say taxol is extracted. Taxol is extracted, which is used for cancer. See, Himalaya nahi hota, so you should understand. तीन बड़ी कंपनियां नहीं होती, एक तो हिमालयन, हिमालय खुद, दूसरी पतंजलि, तीसरी डाबर. ये तीनों कंपनियां एग्जिस्ट नहीं करती. दे आर ऑल बेस्ड ऑन द रॉ मटेरियल्स टेकन फ्रॉम द हिमालयस. टूरिज्म इंक्लूडिंग इको टूरिज्म सिक्स्थ. द एक्ट एज एन डिफेंस बैरियर. ये सब छोटे छोटे पॉइंट्स है. क्या नहीं, कल्चरल वैल्यू इज समथिंग डिफरेंट. कल्चरल वैल्यू मीन्स रिलेटेड टू द कल्चर, जिसका मटेरियलिस्टिक बेनिफिट नहीं है. टूरिज्म इंक्लूडिंग इको टूरिज्म, इको टूरिज्म हम अलग से ही करेंगे. व्हाट यू मीन बाय इको टूरिज्म? दे एक्ट एज अ डिफेंस बैरियर. आज भी सब्सटेंशियल डिफेंस बैरियर है. दे आर नॉट द बेस्ट डिफेंस बैरियर. जो फाइटर जेट्स को तो नहीं रोक सकते, बट एटलीस्ट दे आर प्रोटेक्टिंग अस फ्रॉम टैंक्स. एटलीस्ट दे आर प्रोटेक्टिंग अस फ्रॉम द आर्मीज, from the hostile neighbors. So unka importance have been reduced with the coming up of ballistic missiles, intercontinental missiles and with the coming up of air power. Still they are good defense barrier. What soft power of India? Himalayas. अब मुझे नहीं पता ये सॉफ्ट पावर हो सकता. So you can take down mineral resources. Mineral resources. The Himalayas are rich in metallic minerals such as copper. Metallic minerals such as copper, lead, zinc, and gold. Iron kam hai, copper, lead, zinc, and gold. The Himalayan rock salt. Himalayan rock salt. Himalayan rock salt. In the bracket, pink salt. Pink salt is used in traditional medicines. Is used in traditional medicines as well as aromatherapy. As well as aromatherapy. What is aromatherapy? Aromatherapy is a kind of a traditional healing system जिसमें कुछ smell करके because of the chemicals inside. So how is the rock salt used? Rock salt has a property when it evaporates. It is very rich in magnesium. Secondly, rock salt will kill all the viruses in the room and इसीलिए high energy लगता है after taking the Himalayan rock salt. Next, viruses also. बाहर भी तो होंगे क्या? बाहर मतलब ऑन एनी अदर कैरियर, ऐसे नहीं हवा में. बैक्टीरिया तो मरेगा ही, बट वायरस इज ऑल्सो. नेक्स्ट, द शिवालिक्स आर वेरी गुड सोर्स ऑफ. द शिवालिक्स आर वेरी गुड सोर्स ऑफ. द शिवालिक्स आर वेरी गुड सोर्स ऑफ लाइमस्टोन. Limestone. Coal. Coal is found in Jammu and Kashmir. Kaun sa region? Kalakot. Coal is found in Jammu Kashmir, Kalakot and Arunachal, where? Namchik, Namfuk. Namchik, Namfuk. Karakoram ne kaha. Karakoram ne kaha. Pura Himalayas. Pura Himalayas. And tertiary coal, you find here only the tertiary coal. And lastly, anthracite, not bituminous. Only place in India jahan anthracite is found is Kalakot, but not in, you can say, in high amount you can exploit it. Exploit nahi kar sakte. Last, petroleum in India was first discovered in Himalayas. Petroleum in India was first discovered in Himalayas. Petroleum in India was first discovered in Himalayas, in the upper Assam region. In the upper Assam region. In the upper Assam region, first discovered in Himalayas. Lastly, in the recent times, in the recent times. The government of India is thinking of utilizing excess water from the Himalayan rivers. And transferring it to water deficit peninsular region. Known as interlinking of the rivers. Fine with this? So you can just write the direct answer here. The Himalayas are more than the defense barriers. Fine with this? And only for prelims. Just remember this diagram. Don't write this Punjab Himalayas. This is how we divide the Himalayas. Western between the rivers, then central, then eastern Himalayas. There is one more, what is known as regional division of the Himalayas, that is not that important. It's like diagram diya hai aapke 11th standard NCERT mein. So I'll include that in the excessive, jo extra resources hai, jo hum karenge parso ke lecture mein. Kal hai. NCERT का रिवीजन परसों है, नहीं वो रीजनल डिविजन्स में आएगा. कैन आई गेट दिस? Now open your atlas and come to the state of Arunachal. Important only. Now before I go to the Arunachal, map of Arunachal, Northeast India, before I go, one small question I am asking you, which is the largest northeastern state by area? Assam, Meghalaya, Arunachal, Sikkim, Assam. So you can take down largest of all the seven sisters. Ye hai simple mistakes. Assam is a smaller state, Arunachal is larger than Assam. It is the largest of all the seven sisters. Arunachal. Arunachal. It is the largest of all the seven sisters. Seven sisters matlab? Northeastern states. क्या हाँ है मैंने बोला मेघालय है उसमें हिमालयस डू नॉट पास थ्रू मेघालय बट इट इज इंक्लूडेड इन द रीजनल काउंसिल इट इज द लार्जेस्ट ऑफ ऑल द सेवन सिस्टर्स इट इज गिवन ग्रेटर देन आसाम इतना याद रखना वर्ड मीन्स अरुणाचल मीन्स एनीबडी फ्रॉम अरुणाचल It means dawn-lit mountains. It is dawn-lit mountains. Dawn-lit mountains. Dawn-lit mountains. Next, polity. Tell me, Lok Sabha mein kitni seats, Rajya Sabha mein kitni seats? Ek ek, do do. Question aega, which of the state has the least yeah the state seats in the Rajya Sabha or Lok Sabha? So Lok Sabha, remember two, Rajya Sabha one. ये सब आपको लक्ष्मीकांत के टेबल में से देखना पड़ेगा सबसे ज्यादा कौन भेजता है सबसे कम कौन भेजता है सो सबसे कम गोवा सिक्किम अरुणाचल या ऑल आर सेम सो लोकसभा दो राज्यसभा वन इज इट अ स्पेशल कैटेगरी स्टेट फिफ्थ शेड्यूल सिक्स्थ शेड्यूल So go home and find out fifth or sixth schedule. Article 371 A B C D E F G H क्या है? Go home and find out. ऐसे ही पढ़ाई होगी नहीं तो मैं सिर्फ लिखाऊंगा यहां पे तो नहीं देखोगे. So find out schedule, find out the article 371 ही देखो. डी के बाद देखो चलो आपको वो भी आसान कर देता हूं सो नॉट ई सो नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट हाईकोर्ट कौन सा है ईटानगर और गुवाहाटी गुवाहाटी सो यू नो दिस गुवाहाटी हाईकोर्ट व्हाट इज दिस बाउंड्री नोन एज मैकमोहन लाइन वी ऑल्सो नो दिस मैकमोहन लाइन Religion? नॉर्थ ईस्ट में इस्लाम कहां से आएगा क्रिश्चियनिटी बुद्धिज्म दिस इज वेरी सिंपल मतलब बट वॉट आई वॉन्ट यू टू रिमेंबर इज डोनी पोलो रिलीजन इज फॉलोड बाय मैनी पीपल इन दैट रीजन सो ये याद रखना डोनी पोलो रिलीजन Donipolo religion. Donipolo religion considers sun and moon as only the two gods. It is an indigenous religion which believes in the forces of nature. Baki kuch nahi. It considers sun and moon as the god. So, Donipolo, direct culture based question aayega. The Donipolo religion ya state in India. Tribes. बहुत सारे ट्राइब्स है बट वॉट यू शुड रिमेंबर द ओनली इंपॉर्टेंट ट्राइब्स वी हैव डन एंड सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट which is Monpa tribe, the Monpa tribe. Why it is sabse important? The sixth Dalai Lama belong to this tribe. So wo important nahi hai, matlab Dalai Lama came from this tribe, you remember. So geographical importance is, it is the only nomadic tribe of Northeast India. Baki all are hunters and food gatherers. This is the only nomadic tribe of Northeast India. It is only nomadic tribe. Monpa tribe is the of the Northeast India. Monpa tribe is the only nomadic tribe of entire Northeast India. Second, they are known for world famous. Arunachal. We are doing only Arunachal. They are known for world famous. Thangka paintings. Known for world famous Thangka paintings. What is a Thangka painting? It is a Thangka painting. Silk pe ya cotton pe banaya jata, which shows universe in the center and having different mandalas. Hinduism and Buddhism dono mein common hai, but this is more important because it is made on silk. Thangka paintings, jisme they show the universe at the center, mandala etc. Kaun sa Buddhism hai ye? Mahayana, Hinayana. या वज्रयाना टिबेटियन बुद्धिज्म इज व्हाट सो यू कैन टेक डाउन थांगका पेंटिंग्स हैव यू डन दिस इन आर्ट एंड कल्चर सो यू कैन टेक डाउन थांगका पेंटिंग्स इसलिए मैं करा रहा हूं बिकॉज इट इज इन द न्यूज नथिंग एल्स थांगका पेंटिंग्स इट इज डन ऑन कॉटन एंड सिल्क It is done on cotton and silk, showing mandala, M-A-N-D-A-L-A, mandala, showing mandala, showing mandala. Mandala matlab universe, showing mandala, bhav chakra. सारे बुद्धिस्ट वर्ड्स है आपके एनसीईआरटी में भी ढूंढ के मिलेंगे भाव चक्र दैट इज व्हील ऑफ लाइफ टिबेट में भी बनाया जाता है द सेम पेंटिंग्स सिक्किम में भी यस व्हील ऑफ लाइफ एंड अभिधर्मा मैं कल फोटो दिखा दूंगा Abhidharma, that is art of enlightenment. सिर्फ इतना याद रखना मंडला means what? भावचक्र means what? And अभिधर्मा means what? Nothing else. important rivers all are the tributaries of Brahmaputra. Coming, ये सब हम फिर से आएंगे. Coming in doing Brahmaputra, Subansiri, high chances of because of major hydroelectric power project which was then at the last moment cancelled by National Green Tribunal. Subansiri, a tributary of Brahmaputra. Lohit, a tributary of Brahmaputra. Dihang, Brahmaputra itself. And Dibang, again a tributary of Brahmaputra. Tributary of Brahmaputra. You already know Dafla, Miriya, Bora and Mishmi are what? Shivaliks. Fine? Fine with this? Can I continue? You already know it. This is the state having highest hydroelectric power. Generation potential. Potential. Andhra, I guess. मेरे को चेक करना पड़ेगा एक बार. गोदावरी इज द हाईएस्ट, देखना पड़ेगा एक बार. इंपॉर्टेंट नेशनल पार्क्स, इंपॉर्टेंट नेशनल पार्क्स. सो और इंपॉर्टेंट प्रोटेक्टेड एरियाज. Important protected areas. Nam Dafa Biosphere Reserve. Nam Dafa Biosphere Reserve. Which state again? Arunachal. Aage likho. Has a succession of vegetation from. Tropical evergreen to tundra. Famous for flying squirrel. Famous for flying squirrel. Red panda and Hulog gibbon, the only ape found in India. I've told you regarding the Hulog gibbon earlier also. Only ape and Himalayan musk deer. Second, Dibang. Biosphere Reserve, Dihang Dibang Biosphere Reserve. Not that important, just if state yaad rakhna. Third, Mauring National Park. Mauring National Park, and this is famous for Takin. Famous for Takin. Photo हम बाद में देखेंगे, अभी लिख लो. What is Takin? Goat antelope. Goat antelope. सिर्फ इतना याद रखना, goat antelope. मैं फोटो दिखाऊंगा इन सब के बाद में. Tibetan wild goat. इतना याद रखना, wild goat. Takin. Takin is Tibetan wild goat. Barking what? Dog? Deer. Barking deer. So India mein we have spotted deer, we have barking deer, we have dancing deer. So we have swamp deer. So barking deer kahan pe milta hai, yaad rakho, in northeast India. Pure Himalayas mein. पूरे हिमालयाज में मिलेगा बार्किंग डियर. स्वैम डियर पेनिनसुला में, तराई में भी. दिस यू ऑलरेडी नो नाउ, रेड पांडा. And which I feel this year will be Eagle Nest Wildlife Sanctuary. Eagle Nest Wildlife Sanctuary. Eagle Nest Wildlife Sanctuary. Eagle Nest Wildlife Sanctuary. Which is famous. क्यों ये न्यूज में है? Because of a bird. बुंगुन. स्पेलिंग देखने दो मुझे फिर से. Bungun Leo Chichla. The Bungun Leo Chichla. It's a bird name. Why? Because why it is in the news? Now understand. There is a tribe known as Bungun tribe in Arunachal Pradesh. And they have been awarded by IUCN for the conservation of this bird. Otherwise, this bird was supposed to get extinct. Pichle saal. So ye Bungun. ये जो ट्राइब है ये, एंड दे ओन दिस ईगल नेस्ट वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी. गवर्नमेंट की नहीं है ये वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी. दे ओन दिस वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी एंड दे वन द अवार्ड दिस ईयर ऑल्सो. दे वन द अवार्ड लास्ट ईयर ऑल्सो. सो वेन दे वन द अवार्ड लास्ट ईयर, उनका दूसरा टाइगर रिजर्व दैट इज पाखुई टाइगर रिजर्व केम इन द एग्जाम. आई एम गिविंग यू द बैकग्राउंड वाई दैट केम इन द एग्जाम. पक्के टाइगर रिजर्व जो पिछले साल क्वेश्चन था. सो दिस ईयर अगेन This Eagle Nest Bird Sanctuary is very very important. Getting it? So इससे आपको ये भी याद रखना है कि are the wildlife sanctuaries always government owned or they can be private owned also? Yeah. They can be private owned, they can be community owned. We'll later on discuss in environment ecology the first private wildlife sanctuary in India, which is in Karnataka. Privately owned. That is a couple was working in Silicon Valley. They came to India. They saw whatever this the problems in India. They first came and settled in UP. UP ke the wo couple, but they found no response from the people here. They went into Western Ghats. Unko wahan pe response mila regarding the conservation. Puri property bech di USA ki, and today they have set up a biosphere reserve. They have set up a wildlife sanctuary which is much much better conserved than any of the government wildlife sanctuary in that region. It has tigers, it has elephants, it has everything in Karnataka. Understanding this? So one is Bungun. So remember, Bungun tribe bhi aa sakta hai, indirect question. So Bungun tribe, again which? Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh. Fine with this? सो आपका काम है अरुणाचल प्रदेश इन विच शेड्यूल, व्हाट इज द स्पेशल रोल ऑफ गवर्नर देयर, एंड सेकेंडली विच आर्टिकल फॉर अरुणाचल प्रदेश, और बाकी कितने स्टेट्स है जो वन मेंबर भेजते हैं फ्रॉम राज्यसभा, सिक्किम, गोवा, कौन से ऐसे स्टेट्स है, यू विल हैव टू फाइंड आउट, डोंट गो. मनु अंदर अंदर आ जाए, किसी को भेज दे. How is your polity going on? How is your polity going on? Your polity will be regular from this Saturday. Before I end, मैं एक question पूछना है आपसे कि are you ready for to come double for some classes? ऑप्शनल अभी खत्म हो चुका है, 8:30 से 11 नहीं, जैसे आपकी 5 बजे खत्म हो जाती है तो 5:30 से 8 अब स्लॉट फ्री है. जो मेंस का टॉपिक है सोशल इश्यूज जैसा, जो हल्का टॉपिक है थोड़ा नहीं, जय सर. कैन आई कंटिन्यू? What is the answer for this? You will all get this in the question answer format also. What is the answer for this? The alpine, is it visible to everyone? The alpine vegetation in the western Himalayas is found only up to the height of 3000 meters, while in the eastern Himalayas it is found up to the height of 4000 meters. Alpine means thoda cold. The reason behind this is eastern Himalayas are higher than western Himalayas. True or false? False. Eastern Himalayas are nearer to the equator and sea coast than the western Himalayas? Yes. Because they are nearer to the sea coast, they have tropical vegetation at the base. Because tropical vegetation hai, to alpine vegetation thoda upar push ho gaya. Understanding this? Yeah, eastern Himalayas are not higher than the western Himalayas. Western Himalayas are higher. Koi doubt hai is question mein? Fine. Eastern Himalayas get more monsoon rainfall. True but irrelevant. Inhone alpine vegetation pucha hai, matlab cold. So why cold forest is found at a greater height? In simple words they have asked you. Because bottom pe there is a tropical warm forest. Why tropical warm forest is there? Because it is nearer to the equator. One general question. Which of the following range is spread 1995 ka in only one state in India? अरावली, सतपुराज, अजंता, सह्याद्री. सो अरावली इज वेयर दे स्टार्ट, गुजरात. वेयर दे एंड, दिल्ली. एक स्टेट है नहीं. सतपुराज वेयर दे स्टार्ट, गुजरात. वेयर दे एंड, छत्तीसगढ़. अजंता वेयर इट इज, महाराष्ट्र. सह्याद्री दे स्टार्ट फ्रॉम गुजरात, देन महाराष्ट्र, देन गोवा, कर्नाटका, तमिलनाडु एंड केरला. सो द आंसर इज अजंता. वी हैव मार्क्ड एक जमाने में अजंता, इफ यू रिमेंबर, अजंता बालाघाट रेंजेस. हमने हरिश्चंद्रा रेंज, अजंता बालाघाट रेंज ये मार्क किया था. सो आज जाके देख लेना अजंता, या बाद में भी देख सकते हो, मतलब क्लास के बाद ही. फाइन. अरेंज द फॉलोइंग माउंटेन्स फ्रॉम नॉर्थ टू साउथ. काराकोरम, काराकोरम के बाद लद्दाख, लद्दाख के बाद जास्कर, जास्कर के बाद पीर पंजाल. सो द आंसर इज बी. एनी डाउट हियर? डायग्राम इज देयर इन आवर बुक. यस्टरडे, डे बिफोर यस्टरडे वी मेड दिस डायग्राम. फाइन विद दिस? यू विल नो टू, यू विल हैव टू गेस टू. ऐसे बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस होंगे विच विल कम बाय निगेशन. सो क्या पता है हमें? 100% डेक्कन ट्रैप्स, क्रिटेशियस. फाइन. सो ए थ्री, बाकी ये सारे एग्जाम में ऐसे हेल्प करना, जो सी एंड डी है वो कैंसिल कर देना, उसके तरफ देखना भी नहीं है. फाइन. पहले ही फिर यू विल गेट कंफ्यूज्ड. फिर देखो हमें इसमें से कौन सा पता है. अरावलीस प्री कैम्ब्रियन, सी टू. आगे आंसर देखना और किसी ऑप्शन में है वो ए थ्री सी टू बी. डोंट थिंक कि बाकी का क्या होगा. जो है दैट इज द गुड थिंग अबाउट मैच द कॉलम. यू डोंट हैव टू वरी अबाउट द अदर थिंग्स यू डोंट नो. फाइन. बट आज जब हम, बट जब आप टेस्ट सीरीज करते हो देन यू शुड नॉट डू दिस वे. आपको राइट आंसर पता है बिकॉज ऑफ टू इनपुट्स, बाकी के आंसर्स यू शुड लर्न. अंडरस्टैंडिंग? सो बी वन, that is western ghats belong to late cenozoic. here ye this is, and you will see past year questions agar karoge to many questions come from the same areas. upsc ke again I am saying you, western ghats har saal milega aapko exam mein. narmada tapi alluvial deposits, see this upsc will give you hint also. narmada tapi deposits karte alluvial kyu, kyunki alluvial deposits belonging to the pleistocene. fine with this? एलुवियल डिपॉजिट्स मतलब मेड बाय रिवर, पूरा नर्मदा एंड तापी में. नर्मदा एंड तापी ने कुछ डिपॉजिट तो किया. व्हाट इज द आंसर फॉर दिस? Some people in Manipur live in a house built on the floating islands of weeds and decaying vegetation held together by suspended silt. These are called, not these people, these are called. So, मैं अगर एग्जाम देता आपके जगह तो मैं सिर्फ इतना देखता, floating, decaying, answer fumdis. Fine? पूरा इसलिए देखो मणिपुर भी, क्योंकि floating fields are even in Bangladesh. Fine? डायरेक्ट ऑप्शन देख के भी न मत करो, क्योंकि फिर यू विल नॉट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन. फाइन. नंदा देवी फॉर्म्स अ पार्ट ऑफ कुमाऊं हिमालयस, उत्तराखंड. एनी डाउट हियर? अब इतने सिंपल क्वेश्चन नहीं आते, वो और एरिया कम कर रहे हैं, बट क्वेश्चंस का नेचर देखो वही है. एंड Which of the following cities is near the Tropic of Cancer? See the answer. See, you have atlas. कोलकाता और नागपुर. नागपुर आंसर इज बी कोलकाता. आंसर इज बी नागपुर थोड़ा नीचे है. कैन आई गो टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट क्वेश्चन. आंध्र प्रदेश हैज द लॉन्गेस्ट कोस्ट लाइन, ट्रू और फॉल्स? गुजरात हैज द हाईएस्ट नंबर ऑफ एयरपोर्ट्स? रॉन्ग. आंसर इज डी. फाइन. अगेन अ मैप बेस्ड क्वेश्चन. लेक सांबर इज नियर टू विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सिटीज ऑफ राजस्थान? लेक सांबर इज नियर वेयर? आंसर इज जयपुर. सांबर लेक इज वेरी नियर टू जयपुर. गेटिंग इट? आई गेस एवरीवन इज फॉलोइंग दिस. पीछे सम जीके बेस्ड क्वेश्चन विच वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग रिवर्स ओरिजिनेट फ्रॉम अमरकंटक? आंसर इज नर्मदा एक जगह, दूसरी जगह सोन. अमरकंटक प्लाटू याद रखना, रेडियल ड्रेनेज हमने किया था. सो नर्मदा. फाइन. फिर खुद ही से पूछो, मतलब हमारा लेक्चर होने के बाद 3 दिन बाद, दामोदर कहां से ओरिजिनेट होती है, महानदी कहां से एंड तापी कहां से? ये तो आज ही किया हमने. इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग नामचिक नामफुक कोल्ड फील्ड्स आर लोकेटेड? अरुणाचल प्रदेश. सम फ्रॉम प्रीवियस पार्ट्स विच वी हैव डन. स्टेटमेंट वन, ट्रॉपिकल डेजर्ट्स ऑकर अलोंग द वेस्टर्न मार्जिन्स ऑफ द कॉन्टिनेंट्स विद इन द ट्रेड विंड बेल्ट, ट्रू और फॉल्स? ट्रू. इन इंडिया द ईस्ट हिमालयन रीजन गेट्स हाई रेन फ्रॉम नॉर्थ ईस्ट विंड्स. फॉल्स. कहां से आती है? साउथ वेस्ट विंड्स. सो आंसर इज करेक्ट, वन ओनली. Which one of the following is the appropriate reason for considering the Gondwana rock as the most important? Gondwana matlab what you have to search? Coal. 98% of India's coal. So yahan pe inhone diya more than 90%. So right. Fine. If there were no Himalayan ranges, 2010 again, what would have been the most likely geographical impact? Much of the country would have experienced cold waves? Yes. Indo-Gangetic plains would be divided off? Yes. The pattern of monsoon would be different? Yes. So the answer is D. 1, 2, 3. Fine. We have done this earlier. Between India and East Asia, the navigation time and the distance can be greatly reduced by which of the following? Deepening the Malacca Strait. Kahan pe hai Malacca Strait? Singapore. Fine. Or opening a new canal across the Kra Isthmus. Now, is samay you have to make in your rough work a quick diagram. So, so this is the Strait of Malacca, this is the Isthmus of Kra. Ab question kya pooch raha hai? Navigation distance can be reduced. So navigation distance between India aise reduce hoga. Why it will be reduced here? And dekho, logical hai bahut. Agar pata bhi nahi hai to UPSC kaise hint deti hai? Distance kabhi deepening se reduce hoga? Deepening the Malacca Strait. डीप करोगे तो क्या और बड़ा जहाज जाएगा? ऐसा थोड़ी है कि डिस्टेंस विल बी रिड्यूस्ड. सो यूज योर हेड. सो वैसे ही आंसर रॉन्ग है. डीपनिंग से कभी डिस्टेंस रिड्यूस नहीं हो सकता. 2011. दिस आर द हिंट्स यू हैव टू लुक फॉर इन द आंसर. एग्जांपल, द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द फर्स्ट फ्लोर एंड द ग्राउंड फ्लोर कैन बी रिड्यूस्ड. यस, डीपनिंग तब हो सकता है, बट हियर हॉरिजॉन्टल डिस्टेंस की बात कर रहे हैं. ओपनिंग अ न्यू कनाल Kra Isthmus between Gulf of Siam, Thailand and Andaman Sea. They hint there between the Gulf of Siam and Andaman Sea. And the Andaman Sea, yes. So the answer is 2 only. Getting it? Andaman Sea or Thailand ke beech, agar humne naya canal banaya, to obviously distance reduce hua. So kabhi exam mein itna yaad rakhna, don't panic. Which of the following pairs, that is 10 degree channel, Andaman and Nicobar. Nicobar and Sumatra? Koi channel nahi. Maldives and Lakshadweep? 8 degree channel. Sumatra and Java? 10 degree? 8 degree? And Sunda or Java Strait? Sunda Strait. Find this, when with this. Can I go to the next question? When you travel through the Himalayas, you will see deep gorges. Yes, U-turn river courses, syntaxial bend, parallel mountains, and steep slopes causing landslides. Which of the following statement is or correct? Answer is all. Fine. It's very simple. So do we find snow leopard in the Himalayas? Yes. Do we find clouded leopard in the Himalayas? Yes. Yaad rakhna, both snow leopard and the clouded leopard is only in the Himalayas. Clouded leopard lower height pe and snow leopard upper height pe. Normal leopard कहीं पे भी, मेरे घर के पास आ जाना, इतना ज्यादा डेवलपमेंट हुआ है. आई विल शो यू सम ऑफ द लेपर्ड्स रात को इसके पास. सो वेस्टर्न घाट से लेपर्ड्स आर कमिंग एंड एंटरिंग द फार्म्स हियर. सो दिस इज व्हाट इज द क्लाउडेड लेपर्ड. अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस व्हाट इज द क्लाउडेड लेपर्ड. यू कैन सी फोटो, अच्छी तरह से देखना, पीछे पेड़ है, not snow. So clouded leopards along the lower foothills of the Himalayas, snow leopard in the higher upper ranges of the Himalayas. This is the snow leopard. Getting it? So the difference between the clouded leopard and the snow leopard. Fine. So thank you. We'll meet tomorrow.